I'm going to start by draining the coolant and getting the radiator out of the way. Now to remove the turbo. This is a lot easier than it normally would be, as it's already been apart to diagnose that the turbo was actually the culprit causing the trouble.